all. Today we are going to discuss sampling theory. Here main one is random sampling. Main applications of this sampling theory is a large number of analysis is carried out. Example, the process control, product quality control for consumer safety and environmental control purpose. The purpose of sampling is to provide various types of statistical information of qualitative and quantitative nature about the whole by examining a few selected units. So here few examples, few definitions. So that is, a finite subset of the universe is called sample. The number of individuals in a sample is called sample size. So if the sample size less than 30, it is denoted by small n, and then the sample is said to be small. Otherwise, it is large. The process of selecting sample from the population is called sampling. The process of selecting sample from the population is called sampling. The selection of an individual or item from the population in such way that each has the same chance of selected is called as random sampling. Suppose sample size n from a finite population of size capital N, then possible samples ncn. Sampling where member of the population selected more than once is called sampling with replacement. Sampling with replacement. So sampling where member of population selected more than once, that is sampling with replacement. So if a member cannot be chosen more than once is called sampling without replacement. Chosen more than once, it is called sampling without replacement. Suppose we have different samples of size n drawn from a population. For each and every sample of size n, we can compute quantities like mean and standard deviation, etc. Obviously, these characteristics according to their frequencies. The frequency distribution, so generated as sampling distribution of mean and standard deviation, etc. So another one is, the standard deviation of sampling distribution is also called standard error. Standard deviation of sampling distribution is also called standard error. So another one is, addition regarding the population through a sample of population to make a certain assumption referred to as hypothesis, which may or may not be true. So the hypothesis formulated for the purpose of its rejection under assumption is true. That is called null hypothesis and is denoted by H naught. Any hypothesis which is complementary to the null hypothesis is called alternative hypothesis. Alternative hypothesis means it's complementary to the null hypothesis, that is called alternative hypothesis and is denoted by H1. So another one is, in a test process, four possible situations of which two of the situations leads to the types of errors. So the main leads to the types of errors, that is two types are there, type 1, type 2 errors, that is given here in the form of table. That is, first one is accepting the hypothesis, rejecting the hypothesis. Next, row wise, hypothesis is true, hypothesis is false. Then both this hypothesis true, accepting the hypothesis is the correct decision, and hypothesis is true, rejecting the hypothesis, wrong decision, that is called type 1 error. Hypothesis is true, rejecting the hypothesis, that is called, that is wrong decision, that is called type 1 error. Next, hypothesis is false, accepting the hypothesis, so that is wrong decision, that wrong decision is type 2 error. So next one, hypothesis false and rejecting the hypothesis, that is the correct decision. So this the main situations to leads the two types of error, type 2 types error, that is type 1, type 2 errors. When it will happens means, this is hypothesis true, rejecting the hypothesis, then wrong decision, that is type 1 error. Hypothesis is false and accepting the hypothesis, that is the wrong decision, that is type 2 errors.